What's up guys, welcome back van onder Yu-Gi-Oh! Pro Duel video, next match, Crossbell Nest Cup, second match, or at least 8th match in total, a second match here in Group D. Two kind of underdog decks right here in the tournament, and also in this group, first of all, we have Lightsworns, one of the few Lightsworn lists slash engines, or at least one of the decks that contains a Lightsworn engine, right? Lightsworn Rulers from 2014, I believe second place runner-up at our European Championship back in 2014. You know, one copy of each Dragon Ruler bar the title, right? It was because of Mermails back in 2014 due to, you know, their matchup at something like Mind Control. Pretty straightforward list, Double Wing Blast, one of Breakthrough Skill and Needlebug's Nest, right? Saw play during that short time period. Second list, we have Insectors from 2012. Again, if I'm not mistaken, pretty much the one of the best periods metagames for Insectors, right? Pretty much at full force with Triple Dragonfly, Triple Centipede and Triple Hornet. And backed up with the Solemn Judgment Triple Typhoon, right? Triple Maxi made some changes, small changes, compared to the list I've had up last month, you know, in the deck presentation video. So which deck has the advantage? It should be 50-50, right? We have Lightsworn set 2, have the capability to, you know, OTK with a lot of boss monsters, JD, the Light Lord, Dragon type, right? Bouncing back a set card. Although, on the other hand, same for Insectors. Possibly OTKing your opponent. So, yeah, seems like a bit 50-50 for me. So let's not waste any more time. Let's hop in into the first game. Okay, first duel, and I think I get to start. Indeed, Lightsworns get to start. The opponent is going second this time. This is definitely a good opening hand if you're able to, you know, send Eclipse from either your deck or, you know, discard it off of your Limina to the graveyard to get this banished effect. That's all fine, either banishing the Light Lord or your Judgment Dragon. I eventually opt, well, you're playing against Insectors, right? Insectors like to punish your opponent from, for establishing their board, right? So against Insectors, you have to play somewhat different. Like, not really committing that much to the field, but that leaves you with the risk of, you know, your opponent OTKing if they have, like, the right combination of, you know, popping your own stuff like Zekt Calibur and establishing a nice field. Due to the Maxi, I think I have to go for it, right? Even though you'll get, I think, 2 draws out of the Maxi, but having that one of Gorse, which is pretty much his only outright of stopping, like, an OTK from the opponent in this case. But he did have it, and I think I'm fine giving him a couple of extra draws off of the Maxi due to Big Eye gaining control of the level 7 token, the 3k beatstick, and going for Felgrand. Again, his Monster Reborn is already off of the field, or, you know, is already played, so keeping or possibly quote-unquote negating his normal summon of an Insector, I should be in a very good position thanks to Felgrand, right? But he again at one of his few follow-ups in the form of Dark Iron Dragon, same for the first turn Leo play, right? Well, at least for me, since I thought, well, Leo should be good against Insectors, right? Can't be targeted, so that should be decent. But again, good play on his part with Monster Reborn on Blaster and the Giga Brilliant, I believe the name is. So game number 2, Lightsworns are leading. He opts to start. That's a definitely a good start. Typhoon is pretty much useless against Lightsworn. Stride, he does have a couple of options, but most of the time, well, it's just better to leave your Insectors on the field, right? Again, just if your opponent cannot get rid of them, you can just start popping stuff during the next turn again. So rarely it will be the good play to exceed away all of your Insector monsters. But again, the first turn Leviathan, which is all fine. Just a small beatstick, right? But get that Insector Dragonfly back in the graveyard. And this is definitely a good play, going for Steel Swarm Roach, negating any inherent, indeed, special summon like Cyber Dragon, Judgment Dragon, Light Ruler, indeed. But yeah, only 3 Lightsworn monsters in my graveyard here, not enough light targets for the Diabolos, and Judgment Dragon cannot be special summoned. That Book of Moon was definitely a good play on his part, not let me discard the card. Possibly the 4th Lightsworn, right? But then again, he did have, like, the Steel Swarm Roach on his side of the field. So, yep, definitely a good play on his part. So, a much slower now game number 3. I get to start Normal Summon Curry Bennett. excavating right the top 5 cards of my deck. Hopefully one of them, at least one of them, is like a spell card. Solar Recharge is good. Setup Breakthrough Skill, definitely very nice to keep, well, my opponent from, you know, vomiting everything to the field, and keep, like, the pace of the duel very, very slow. Definitely Breakthrough Skill. The Centipede here prevent him from maybe using something like Hornet or Dragon... Hornet... Is it Dragonfly? No, it's not Dragonfly. That's, Ladybug. That's indeed the name. The level 2 one. Anyway, again, the Maxi must be nice, right? Drawing those Maxis. But then again, I do have Ring Blast to, you know, prevent or at least interrupt any of my opponent's plays. Same for Rainbow Kuribo, prevent the possible OTK. But I have to watch out, right? Since Rainbow Kuribo does equip to my opponent's monster. So, like, equipping to, like, a Centipede or Dragonfly, that can be, could be dangerous. Here, he maybe activates his Book of Moon a little bit too early, but you will see later it didn't really matter that much. But yeah, popping the JD, and eventually I think I have the Rainbow Kuribo, right? But as you, well, it didn't really matter again in the long run. Dropping the JD, the Forbidden Lens coming in clutch, protecting JD, using its effect, you know, blowing up the entire field. Here is where he could have used the Book of Moon to chain on the Forbidden Lens, but then I definitely would have used my, is it Blaster that I have in the graveyard to get back, like, another copy of JD that was banished off of an eclipse. So, and you will see that during the next turn, I still have a third copy ready thanks to the on-field eclipse. Yeah, a third copy of Judgment Dragon banished to, you know, use it now during my next turn here to eventually go for a game. Since Sand Mains is not enough due to the Engrave Breakthrough skill that was, I believe, sent to the graveyard during the first turn, at least, well, off of Recharge, I believe. But it's not going to matter too much. Again, thanks to all the boss monsters coming in clutch, Lightsworn scan attack for a game. So, a good game. Long game. But, yeah, Lightsworns do take the 2 points here, and Insectors will take up 1 point. So the next matchup, Group E should follow very soon, also containing a lot of big names. Draco Pals, Tidal Mermails, Trishalai Infernity, Teladat. All those names. Yeah, first of all, Draco Pals, Tidal Mermails should follow maybe early next week. Okay, guys, that's it. Thanks for watching, and feel free to leave a comment or like if you enjoyed the video. Liam signing out. Peace.